Good morning, dear student. Welcome to you in today's lecture of English. Student, in today's lecture, we are going to discuss question answers of third one lesson and the name of it, the language of Lars, which had been already completed in previous lecture. So, student, let me start. So, just take out your book and open your book page number 18 and as well as just take out your notebook also. So, I hope you have completed the word meaning first of all in your notebook. So, once again, I'm going to just tell you that whenever you start in a new lesson, first of all, you must have just complete the word meaning which is given in your book in vocabulary section. So, it is compulsory to complete the word meaning in your notebook. Now, let me see the next question. Choose the correct answer. First of all, just make it complete this exercise in your book. Then, after completing the question answers, you may just complete it in your notebook. So, the first one. What words does the author use to describe the bunch of flowers as unusual? What word does author use? Which word had been used by the author to describe a bunch of flowers which is unusual? जो अच्छी किस्म के फ्लावर के लिए या बुके के लिए कौन सा वर्ड author ने यहाँ use किया है? So the first one, the correct one answer is for it, bizarre and peculiar. The bouquet which was bizarre and peculiar. Bizarre means strange, peculiar, which ajeeb sa. Now, the second one, which odd item was included in the bouquet? Which odd item, kaun sa odd item tha jo bouquet mein include kiya gaya tha? Asparagus, poison ivy or feathers? Asparagus. What is the correct one answer? Yes, it is asparagus. Asparagus, it's not any flower. It's a tall plant of a lily family, which is not used for the bouquet. So the correct one answer for the second is A, asparagus. Now the next one, which flower signifies bad luck and would not be a part of British bouquet? Which flower signifies bad luck? Which flower signifies bad luck and it doesn't a part of a bouquet of a British bouquet? So it is hawthorn. Hawthorn, which is having thorn, jisme thorn hote, kaante hote. So we never use any kind of flower which is having a thorn in a bouquet. Now the next one, what is the other name for May? What is the other name for May? The other name for May is hawthorn. Now the next one, who seemed to have sent the flowers? Who seemed to have sent the flowers? So who seemed to have sent the flowers means what do you think when the bouquet is presented to Mrs. Watson? So what do you think? Is it presented by any friend or any enemy? So what she was thinking, that the bouquet, it was presented by any enemy because it was not a good time or it was not the correct time to give a bouquet, because her husband has been vanished and missing for last 3 days. So I repeat the answers once again. The first one is A, bizarre and peculiar. Second, asparagus. Third, hawthorn. Fourth, hawthorn. And the fifth one, an enemy. Now let us see the next question. Answer these questions in brief. Label the flowers in the bouquet received by Mrs. Watson. Label the flowers in the bouquet received by Mrs. Watson. Here you can see one of the flower, one of the bunch is there, and bouquet is there, and some flowers name that you have to just write it over there as a homework. So it's homework I am giving to you, that you have to just make it complete. The flower's name is missing and you have to just do it. So first of all, try it yourself and then I'll explain you it tomorrow. Now let me discuss the next question. Question number 32. Why has Mrs. Watson received the flower? Why has Mrs. Watson received the flower? Mrs. Watson ko ne flowers ko jo kaha tha wo kyun diya tha? Mrs. Watson received the flowers as a sign of consolation. As a sign of consolation, you know, कि वो कोई उसे console करने के लिए आया था, कोई उसे दिलासा देने के लिए आया था, because her husband Mr. Watson had been missing for 3 days. However, she received a peculiar bouquet. So, however, she received a peculiar bouquet. So, just note it down. This answer, Mrs. Watson received the flower as a sign of consolation, डिफरेंस बिटवीन नॉस्के एंड बुके. बुके और नॉस्के में क्या डिफरेंस होता है? अ नॉस्के इज अ स्मॉल बंच ऑफ थ्री फ्लावर्स. व्हाट डज इट मीन बाय नॉस्के? अ नॉस्के इज अ स्मॉल बंच ऑफ थ्री फ्लावर, वेयर एज अ बुके इज अ लार्ज बंच ऑफ 100 फ्लावर्स. सो बुके, बुके में जो फ्लावर यूज किए होते हैं वो ट्रिम नहीं होते, है ना, उसके जो हम स्टेम देखते हैं इज लॉन्ग. ओके, बट व्हाइल व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द नॉस्के, इट्स अ स्मॉल बंच ऑफ ट्रिम फ्लावर, उसके जो फ्लावर्स होते हैं वो ट्रिम किए हुए होते हैं. सो जस्ट कॉपी डाउन द सेंटेंस. नॉस्के इज अ स्मॉल बंच ऑफ ट्रिम फ्लावर, वेयर एज अ बुके इज अ लार्ज बंच ऑफ 100 फ्लावर्स. नाउ लेट मी सी द नेक्स्ट वन, द फोर्थ वन क्वेश्चन. व्हाट वर द ग्रीन्स, व्हाट वर द ग्रीन्स, व्हाट वाज पेक्युलियर अबाउट देम? The greens in the bouquet was asparagus. So what was the green there in the book, in that bouquet which was received by Mrs. Watson? The greens in the bouquet was asparagus. The peculiar thing about the asparagus was they were cultivated with a lot of trouble for the bouquet. You know, so just copy it down. It was cultivated with a lot of trouble for the bouquet while they were born in abundance in the country. So generally the florists, they never use any kind of flower and any kind of asparagus in the bouquet because it is having a thorn, or it wasn't used in any bouquet. So just copy down this answer. Now the next one question. How did Enola know the strange item in the bouquet was asparagus? How did Enola know? Enola ko kaise pata tha that it is one of the strange item that was used in the bouquet and that was asparagus. Enola know that strange item was asparagus because her mother was a botanist. Botanist means a person who study about the plant. The plant ke bare mein study karte. So her mother was a botanist and because she had seen them in a bouquet before, and before that she had seen a bouquet which is having an asparagus. उसने ऐसा bouquet पहले भी देखी थी जिसमें asparagus का use किया हुआ था. So just copy it down. Enola knew that strange item was asparagus because her mother was a botanist and because she had seen them in a bouquet before. Now the next question. Identify four words in the last two paragraphs that are unpleasant and frightening and seem to indicate ill intent. So in the last two paragraphs, what we have to find, we have to just find out four words, hai na, hame four words find out karne hai which shows frightening and seem to indicate illness and it is unpleasant. Unpleasant, it's not a good words. So let us see that which words are used. Stealthy, first one, stealthy. First one, stealthy. Stealthy means sneaky or secretive. Next, ominous. Ominous means bad. Next, twisted. What next one? Twisted. And the last one, convoluted. Convoluted means difficult to understand. So these are the four words that have been that has been used in the last two paragraph. Stealthy, ominous, twisted, and convoluted. So students, I repeat the answers once again. Just copy it down in your notebook. Second answer, Mrs. Watson received the flowers as a sign of consolation because her husband, Mr. Watson, had been missing for 3 days. However, she received a peculiar bouquet. Now the third one, a nosegay is a small bunch of three flowers, whereas a bouquet is a large bunch of 100 flowers. Next one, fourth one, the greens in the bouquet was asparagus. What was the green in that bouquet? It was asparagus. Now, the peculiar thing about asparagus was they were cultivated with a lot of trouble for the bouquet. It was cultivated in a lot of trouble for the bouquet while they were formed in abundance in the countryside. Next one, fifth, Enola knew that the strange item was asparagus because her mother was a botanist and she had seen them and she had seen them in a bouquet before. And the last one, the four unpleasant words I have explained you in today's lecture. Now it's time to read the homework. Your today's homework is you have to complete first one exercise, exercise A in your notebook and B. First of all, just make complete question number exercise B in your notebook. What you have to do? You have to just label the name of flower. What you have to do? You have to just label the name of flower. So here, I am writing your today's homework. Just copy down the book. That's what is it? Today's homework is to complete exercise B. First question, where you have to just label the name of flowers. So student, I hope you have understood it very well. Now one more homework I am giving to you. You have to just learn the word meaning also, because many new word meaning you can see on the page number 18. So it's your work to learn the word meaning, and in this way you will just maintain dictionary also. So I hope student you will complete your today's homework today itself, and we'll meet you in next video. Till then, take care and bye bye.